हेलो, दिस इज स्वप्निल ममानी, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस महिला महाविद्यालय तासगांव। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द विजुअल स्टूडियो। विंडोज एप्लीकेशन से वन राइट क्लिक ऑन दैट, एड न्यू आइटम, सिलेक्ट वेब फॉर्म 1.aspx। दिस इज अवर HTML पेज एंड दिस इज अवर डिजाइनर पेज। इन दिस पेज वी हैव टू firstly design the program for code. Today we are going to learn about the drop down list box. It is similar to the list box, but it is a different in look. Now the same program we are going to take, which we already learned in the list box. Simply change the control list box to drop down list box. Now the program design is the same as per the previous program. Text box we have taken here to add values to the first drop down list box, and now the other operations we will done. Transfer values from one drop down list box to other. Selected item we are going to transfer, and also all items we are going to transfer from one to other. At the final we clear all the drop down box. We are changing the captions on the button like this. This is our design page. First is text box 1, again button, when we click on the button the value from text box 1 goes to drop down list box. Now check, is it okay or not. This is drop down list box 2. Is this look fine or not? Yes. Is this okay? Now code for this program. Double click on the button. Button 1 underscore click event occurred. That is the function name. We are going to set the values for the drop down list 1. That's code is drop down list 1 dot items dot add, which value taken from text box 1. So in the add function pass the values of text box 1 dot text. After that clear the text box, check. Wait for some time. Okay, insert the values. Raj. Click on the button. The values goes to drop down list box 1. It is similar to the previous program list box. Two values we inserted here, Raj and Rajaram. Ramesh. Click on button. Ramesh goes to the drop down list box. Now code for this button, which transfer single value from one drop down list box to second drop down list box. Now click on this button. Button 2 click event occurred. The function name drop down list 2 dot items dot add in bracket drop down list 1 dot selected item, because which item we will select has to be transfer. So selected item text goes to the add function, and after that has to remove from the first drop down list box. So drop down list 1 dot items dot remove in bracket drop down list 1 dot selected item dot text. After adding, we remove from the drop down list box. Now check, is this okay or not? Insert some values. Ramesh. Rajaram. Rajaram goes to the drop down list box 2. Oh, it's working fine. So we are going to for second button, which transfer all the values from drop down list 1 to drop down list 2. For this, we have to use the while or for loop. Now take while loop, checking condition until while loop run until drop down list box items dot count greater than 0, means up to drop down list box 1 is not empty, it will run the while loop. Inside the while loop, drop down list 2 dot items dot add drop down list 1 dot items of 0. It takes the first element of the drop down list box. Now remove the first element, then second elements comes up at the first position. So drop down list 1 dot items dot remove in bracket drop down list 1 dot items of 0 dot text. Okay, now check, all is all okay or not. Insert some values to the list 1, drop down list 1, type anything. Okay, select Raja, goes all values to the drop down list 2. It's okay, fine. Now we are going to create code for clear button. When we press the clear button, it has to be empty the first drop down list box. So the function name is clear, drop down list box 1 dot items dot clear. When we click on the clear button, it will clear. Now the same code for the three buttons, for single value transfer, for all value transfer and the clear, similar to the first drop down list box, has to be created for the second drop down list box. Only change in this program is change the values 1 to 2 and 2 to 1. All the functions code is same. So simply copy paste all the codes from the three functions to next three functions. Change the values to 2 to 1, 1 to 2, here also 1 to 2 and 1 to 2. It works reverse. All do this for three functions which given on the screen. It works similar to the previous three functions. Change these three functions values 1 to 2 and 2 to 1, and last for clear button, it clears the second drop down list box. Now check, insert some values to the first drop down list box. Insert anything. Okay, Ramesh goes here. All the values transferred to drop down list 2. Okay, this goes here. When we click on this button, all the goes to drop down list 1. Now all the goes to drop down list 2 again. Now when we click on the clear, it clears all the drop down list box. So in this way we can work with the drop down list box button similar to the list box. Thank you. To get the more videos of this series, please like, share and subscribe, and please do not forget to press the bell icon to view latest videos. Thank you.